Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to share photos from your Mac with other people online. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So if you want to share some of your photos with other people online, you don't have to upload them to some sort of social network or photo sharing site. You can do it using the Photos app on your Mac and iCloud. So here I am in Photos, and what I want to do is create a shared album. Now I can do that many ways. I can go over here to the shared albums on the left, click the plus button, and create a shared album that way. But it's easier if I start off by selecting some photos, even if they're not all the photos that I want to share, just a few to get started. So I've selected a few photos here. Now I can go to File, Share, and choose Shared Albums. Or I could simply click the Share button here at the top and select Shared Albums. Either way, I'm going to get this popping up here under the Shared icon. Now I need to select the shared album that I want to use. In this case, I haven't created one yet. So I have the ability here to create a new shared album. I'll give it a name. Let's just call this Test. I can invite people to it, but I won't do that just yet. I'm just going to create the album right now. So I'll click Create, and you can see it appear here under Shared Albums. If I select it here, you can see there are the six photos that I've included in the shared album. Now to control how this is shared, I'm going to click this button up here, and I'll see the name. I can change that if I want. Here's where I can now invite people, and I have three options. So when inviting people, you need to use somebody's Apple ID. They can have an Apple ID because they have any Apple product, or they can go to appleid.apple.com and create one for free. You don't have to own an Apple product to do that. Anybody with an Apple ID can be added to this invite list, and then they'll have private access to it. They would need to be logged into their account in their web browser. They could be doing this on any device that has a modern web browser. They don't need to have a Mac or an iPhone or iPad. This allows you to control exactly who sees the photos, to keep them private just among a select group of people. Now when you've invited people, if you have subscribers can post set, then they can post photos to the album as well. So it's truly a shared album. The way they would do this is accept the invitation they're going to get. They're going to get a notification. And then in their Photos app under Shared Albums, they would see this album as well. And they could add photos to it in the Photos app. So if you went on a trip with a bunch of people, you can create one of these, put some of your favorite photos there, and other people can then add their favorite photos to it as well, and you all can view them in the same shared album. However, if you want to make this just an album that you're sharing with people and they can't add their own photos, then uncheck this. Now next, you have the ability to make this a public website. When I select this, I'll get a URL that will appear here with a link. And you can see it here. Now it's unlikely anybody's going to be able to find this unless you post a link to it somewhere. So this is pretty private as well, although not secured. But the advantage of this is you could send anybody this link and they'll be able to go and view the album either in the Photos app if they have an Apple product or in any web browser. So instead of messing around with inviting people using their Apple IDs, you could simply check this, then copy and paste this link into an email or text message and send it to friends so they can see the photos that you've posted. And the last checkbox here is simply for notifications. When you've shared this with people, they can add comments, they could like, and if you've checked this box here, they can add their own photos. And with this checked, you get a notification when that happens. So let's leave these two options on to share an album that nobody else can change. We just want to share our photos with everybody so they can see them. And let's say you sent this link to people. Here's what they would then see if they try to go to it in their web browser. You can see it displays here in Safari, but it works in Chrome, it'll work in Microsoft Edge, it'll work on an Android phone. Anywhere, it will display the photos and they could scroll through them. There are options as well. They could click on a photo and then go into that photo. Depending upon their browser, they could go full screen with it. They could flip between photos or start a slideshow that automatically goes between the photos. They could also click download and download this photo. They don't have to screenshot it or drag the photo out or anything like that. And notice here I'm not logged into iCloud. I don't have to have an Apple ID to do this. This is basically a publicly shared photo gallery. And it's yours. You have control of it. It's not at some social network or some third-party site. Back here in the Photos app, you can delete it anytime using the Delete Shared Album button here, and it goes away. Now once you have a shared album, you can easily add photos or remove photos from it. So let's go back to our library here, and let's say we want to add this one to it. Just drag and drop it. And now it added that one to the album. You also can click this button here and then it will allow you to select photos to add. So I can select a couple here like that, add, and now those are added as well. If I want to delete a photo, I can select it and I can either control click on it and delete from the shared album or just use the delete key and it will delete it from the shared album. It's still in my regular photos library. It's just not shared anymore in this shared album. Also note that you can add comments and like photos in shared albums. So there's a button here at the bottom left hand corner. It looks a little different on the iPhone and iPad. Actually says add comment at the bottom. And here I can like a photo like this and I can add a comment. And other people could do that as well. So if you've shared this with other people and they open it up in their Photos app, they have this same button here and they could click there and add a comment as well. And everybody else who's viewing the shared album can click and see the comments that other people have posted. Notice you have to be at the top level here to have this button and be able to change settings for the entire album. Let's set this so subscribers can post and let me invite someone. So now that person's accepted and you could see the list of people here and the check mark next to people that have accepted, I could remove them from the album if I want. If I go in here and look at the comments, I could see when they do things. For instance, if they liked the photo, you'll see that appear here. You also see it when they add a comment. You get a notification as well because I have that checked. You also see it when they add a comment to the photo as well. So you can see here they just added one. It updated live. I'm going to have that other user add a photo to the album and you're going to see it appear here. And there it goes. So that's a photo there and I could actually go in and comment on that photo. Now here's what happens if somebody invites me to view their shared album. You can see I got a notification here. I'll click on that. It goes into Photos and under Shared Albums you may have noticed there's Activity there. Activity is where I'll see the invitation. So there it says Album Test 2. I can accept or decline. I'll accept. Now Test 2 appears here. I can go to it and see the photos that that person has posted to this shared album. And if they've allowed me to add my own photos, I could do so. Otherwise, I could always go in and comment and like their photos as well. But let's say they just share a public link instead. Then I would get a message from them or maybe an email or something. Here it is with a link and I could click on that and I could go and view the album in a web browser even if I haven't been added to the invite list. And you know you could share these public albums with anybody. So you could post them to social media. Instead of uploading your photos there, you could simply post to your Facebook page that here are all the photos from your trip. Check it out. And the great thing is you can easily update this as well. So you could do this while you're on the trip, constantly adding new photos to the shared album. And those that are interested can keep checking the shared album and see what's new. And you can also share photos with the general public. You could put a link on a website, for instance, and say, here are some of my favorite photos, and let anybody check out an album that you've shared. There are so many options that you can really customize iCloud shared photo albums to fit almost any need for posting photos online. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.